Hello, 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 mabuhay, crazy universe. Welcome, or I must say, welcome back to my channel. It's me again, your ultimate pageant buddy. I'm Ati Bang. Bang, bang! Bang, 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 bang. Yes, yes, yes. Sawadika, namaste, apakabar. And greetings all across the universe and the world. Finally, Miss Universe fever is over. And I would like to congratulate India, Miss Harnesh Sandhu, for winning the Miss Universe 2021 title. After 21 years, you got it, India. So congratulations to all my Indian brothers and sisters. You deserve it. I'm very happy with the result. I'm very satisfied. And wow, what a show. Congratulations. And now, guys, after Miss Universe, let's move on to Miss World. Okay, guys, I feel like Vanessa Varanasi can win the crown. And now I'm looking to the other candidates who might be the biggest hindrance for India to get that crown. And I think that is Miss World Philippines, Tracy Marine Perez, and Miss Cote d'Ivoire. So I'm going to watch this head-to-head final and react to this video. But before that, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell to get notified every time I have a new upload. Let's get started. Oh, yay!
Ati bang 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 bang.
Philippines! Let's hear her speech.
Para kay nanay, for my mother, a single mother's journey to love. That is my Beauty with a Purpose project, and it's dedicated to my late mother and to all the single mothers in my community.
Wow.
Being a mother...
Wow, I mean, the title Para kay nanay is, you know, there's a part in your heart. When we hear the word mom or mother or nanay, there is a part in your heart that really, you know, it's beating so fast. It's really near to our heart. So I think this is going to be emotional.
The most important job is the most important role, yet oftentimes they are neglected. We fight so much, we talk so much about women empowerment. So why don't we start with empowering our mothers, most especially those who go through so much difficulties having to raise their families all on their own. Here in Miss World, we are given the chance to fight for causes, to open up meaningful conversations about problems that are otherwise neglected. And here I am, hoping to bring light and to spark a change, positive changes in the lives of single mothers.
Wow, I mean, she's so good in conveying her message. You can feel that, you know? Yeah, you can feel that it's coming from her heart, and through her, you can feel the essence of the message and her project. Beautiful.
Back in my community in Cordova, Cebu, there are 2,000 single mothers. So imagine how much more there are in the rest of the world. But they are not given the support, they're not given the help that they need. With my project, we give them a safe space, a community for them to feel loved, to feel that they are heard, that they are understood.
Wow.
More importantly, we give them continuous BPO and computer trainings that they can use to equip them with skills to land better opportunities out there, especially amidst the pandemic. It gives them hope that they can still go out there and learn new things and build a good life for their families. Because that is what I want for them. That is what they deserve. And that is what I would have wanted for my mom too if she was still here.
Oh my God.
That is
my... Oh. You know, that word really struck me. There's a heartfelt message. I mean, there's an emotional attachment to this project. And this is very, very personal, very heartfelt. So, wow, Tracy, you are amazing. I can feel the sincerity and the heart of this project.
commitment, and that is my dream. Thank you.
Yeah. Great job. I'm speechless. Like, wow. What?
Next, we have Mexico.
Wow, wow, wow. Tracy Marie and Perez. Wow. Spotlight. Oh my gosh, I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud to be a Filipino because you are there representing all the beautiful Filipino out there. So wow, so proud. I love that. And now guys, let's watch Miss Olivia Yates of Cote d'Ivoire as one of the strongest candidates that I think is going to slay the Miss World 2021.
Next, Cote d'Ivoire.
Cote d'Ivoire.
Raise your hand with me if you believe that everybody deserves access to education. So, when I went to these girls in my country and I saw that they were robbed of their dignity, of their innocence, of their women's rights, telling them that they shouldn't go to school, that they don't have a place in school, that they should stay at home, be housewives, get chores, it made me see the opportunity that we have and how fortunate we are to have education. And it just made me want to help them even more. So when I got the card of Miss Cote d'Ivoire, I looked for these girls and I went out there to see what they wanted to do, what motivated them. And what motivates them is people like me, people like Miss Mexico, people like Miss South Africa, Miss Botswana, who have a dream for them, who just need to pave the way for them, to give them access to this brighter future that they need and that they deserve. And that is what my project is about. It's about women's rights. It's about giving them the education they need, because education is so important.
Okay, all I can say is she's very composed. I love the tone of her voice. I feel it's very sincere and it doesn't sound rehearsed. It's very natural of her speaking right now.
In a kid's life, and it's such an important determinant of who they will be in the future. Thank you.
Wow. You know, it's short, but the content is just massive. You know, the content is really full. I mean, that is very impactful. She has a short speech, but it's very impactful. I love it. I love how she delivered her message. Beautiful.
Thank you, Cote d'Ivoire. Bienvenido a Puerto Rico.
Ooh, wow.
Soy Tracy, enamorada de este país caribeño.
He's so adorable.
Welcome to Puerto Rico. This is Tracy, and I fell in love with Puerto Rico the moment I stepped foot in this Caribbean island.
Oh.
So the very first time I landed here, it was about 2 or 3 weeks ago. And I was looking for my luggages because I have 10 from the Philippines. I didn't know anyone. I didn't know who to contact or how to contact anyone. And lo and behold, this Puerto Ricanya looked at me, smiled at me, approached me and said, "Hello, where are you from? Do you need anything? Do you need internet? Because I have some that I can share with you." And I was blown away. Oh. See, the best places in the world don't really need the most amazing and the most beautiful sceneries. They just have to have the best people.
Amazing.
But you know what? Puerto Rico just happens to have both. From the white sand beaches, the abundant rainforests, the culture, the food, and the people, Puerto Rico has it all.
Amazing.
It took me 40 hours to get here, but it was the best 40 hours of my life, and I will do it all over again just to be here. Thank you. Muchas gracias.
Wow. Well, I think it's over time, but wow, she delivered her message. I love the story that she shared. It's very interesting. It's very personal, and it's true. You know that her story, her experience is just genuine as she is. So I'm very interested to listen about her story. Wow, Tracy Marin. I love it. That's why, no doubt, she's part of the winners of the head-to-head challenge, right? Philippines, come on. Oh my gosh, so proud to be a Filipino.
next we have Côte d'Ivoire.
Côte d'Ivoire.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is quite simple for a Puerto Rican to advertise for their country, but for someone else from another country like me from Côte d'Ivoire to advertise is a whole different story. I've been here for 2, going on 3 weeks, and I can say that I feel right at home. It's so welcoming, the weather, the people, y me encantada por la hospitalidad,
wow,
la cultura, la belleza, somos en paraíso. And I've had the opportunity to talk with the mayor of Rio Grande, and I mentioned that my dad is also the mayor of the biggest city in Côte d'Ivoire, so I understand the hard work, the dedication that comes with his position. So I was so happy to have a conversation with him. I was happy to take a picture of him, send it to my country, tell them all about the beautiful places I've visited in Puerto Rico, Mata La Gata, El Dorado, Old San Juan, and everybody watching back home. I really hope that visiting Puerto Rico is on your New Year's resolution list because it's amazing.
Wow, Olivia is just so charming and, you know, she's sweet. You can feel her authenticity. And I mean, she's like a darling, you know? I like her smile and the way she communicates. She's very eloquent. Wow, I feel like Philippines and Côte d'Ivoire are two of the strongest candidates who's going to hinder the win of Manasa and for them to make a history, you know? So, oh my gosh, I have a lot of favorites for the Miss World. Who are your favorites? Mine? I'm going to release it soon. So if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell to get notified every time I have a new upload. See you again soon. Bye!